Hello everyone, welcome back in today's tutorial on Unix administration. In today's tutorial we are going to see how to achieve file management in Unix environment. So let's start today's session. So before going to jump into how to do the file management in Unix, I have just logged into the one of the terminal in the Unix environment. So you will see the black screen and you can run various commands here. So you can see the commands here. So let's see what. So if you notice in the screen, I can see some blue folder, some green. So these colors we can change, but what does it mean? That is what we are going to learn in today's session. So there are various types of files available in Unix environments, which are broadly classified into three categories. First is called as ordinary files, second is special files, and third is directories. So everything in Unix environment is treated as a file. Ordinary files are files which are responsible for containing data, text, or program instruction. However, special files provide access to hardware such as hard drive, CD-ROM drive, modems, and Ethernet adapters. These are also well known for alias or shortcuts for the ordinary files. And the third type is nothing but the directories. In Windows system we call it a folder, however in Unix system we call it a directories. And directories store both special files as well as ordinary files. So what are the commands associated with files? Suppose if you want to list all the files which are present in my current directory, we have to use ls, that is list files. There is one more option available with ls command, that is minus l. If you use ls minus l, it will give us the list of files along with additional information. There is some additional information here we have given. Whenever you list, let's try to list this file. So let me clear the screen and type the ls. Your ls means it will list all the files, and we know that in a Unix environment files and directories are treated as a files. So that is the reason here all the files are listed. Let's try out ls minus l. If you type ls minus l, it gives the additional information. We will see shortly all the columns, what does it means. So what are the blue colored files we are able to see? These are the folders, and the green color files are nothing but the files. But how I come to know whether this blue color folders or directories or files? So if we see at the very first line, the very first character is D. D stands for directory. If it is an ordinary file, there will be hyphen. If it is D, then directory. If it is hyphen, then it is a file. So that is very simple convention to identify directories and files. So that is what here it is mentioned. Every file line begins with a D hyphen or L. This character indicates the type of file that listed. We are going to see more details. So there are several column, first column, second column, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh column. So those columns are nothing but here. The column one is this one. All the columns are separated by space. So the second column is these characters, 3, 2, 2, etc. This is fourth column, fifth column. Then we have this sixth column. Then 7th, 8th, etc. So 7th is this column, actually the full date. So these are the columns normally available whenever you use ls minus l. And we are going to see all these column details. The first column, it gives the information about the file type and the permissions given on that file. So out of this first, this is the first column. Out of the first column, first character denotes whether it's a directory or file. D stand for the directory, hyphen stand for file. Let's go ahead and see the next detail, the second column. The number of memory blocks taken by the file or directory will be listed in the second column. So for example, AEBPL engine, this directory holds 3 blocks. Desktop directory holds 2 blocks. The file my support holds 1 block. So these are the block information available in the second column, that is memory block. Third column is owner of that file. This is the Unix user who create this file. The fourth column is group of owner. Every Unix user will have an associated group. So third and fourth are related to the owner of file and group of that file. So for example, documents directory has MDM as a owner, as well as there is a MDM group. So these are the information. So sometimes it's possible owner is different and group also different. Fifth column, it is a type, the file size in bytes, how many bytes that file is contains. For example, this is 16 bytes folder directory. This is 4096 bytes directory. These are the information available in fifth column. In sixth column, it is the date and the time when this file was created or modified for the last time. So this is the give the time detail when that file or folder is created. Seventh column give the actual name of file or directory name. So you can see these are this is the seventh column where it is giving the information about the folder name or file name. So these are the details about the information when you use the ls-l. There are some additional information is also mentioned here. In the first column, as we said, there will be D hyphen L. Along with that, there will be additional characters also available. So if the first column starts with a hyphen, it is nothing but a regular file such as ASCII text file, binary executable, or hard link. It's not soft link, it's a hard link. If it is start with a B, means if the first column and the first character start with B, it signifies a block special file, block input or output device file such as a physical hard drive. If the first character is C, it is character special file. It's with raw input or output device file such as physical hard drive. D stand for directory file, which we already know. L stand for symbolic link file, links on any regular file. We'll see how to create links. Means links are nothing but if you're using Windows system, you can create a shortcut of any file or folder, or you can keep those in the desktop so that you can easily access. So on the same line, in Unix system we have the links. Using Linux, you can easily access the physical location of the file or folder, and those links are nothing but treated as a L. L will be the very first character in the first column. If the first column start with P, it is nothing but the named pipe, a mechanism for inter-process communication. So those will be internally used, such files. If the first character start with S, it is a socket used for the inter-process communication. So the files such as S, P or B or C, those are more relevant for the internal processing of your Unix system. So these are the details about the files. I hope this very short tutorial gave you enough idea about the files and directories. Keep watching this space because there are so many important and interesting stuff is coming in upcoming session. Thank you again and have a nice time.